Is phosphorus a semiconductor? Yes, it is a semiconductor. Does a paramagnetic material like copper lose its properties when current flows through it? No, passing current through a paramagnetic material like copper does not cause it to lose its properties. Paramagnetic materials are influenced by magnetic fields, and even when current flows through them, they can maintain their magnetic characteristics. This property means that paramagnetic materials can possess both magnetic and electrical properties simultaneously. Applying heat to semiconductors like silicon or germanium can give them the properties of conductors. Does this process make them magnetic? No. Applying heat to semiconductors like silicon or germanium to make them conductive does not make them magnetic. Magnetism is determined by the spin direction of atoms or molecules within a material, and changes in thermal or electrical properties do not necessarily lead to the development of magnetism. The presence of magnetism would require structural or property changes within the material. Can they become antiferromagnetic, on the contrary? Yes, they can become antiferromagnetic. Antiferromagnetic materials are substances in which the magnetic spins of molecules or atoms align in opposite directions, creating a magnetic ordering. While these materials do not generate an external magnetic field on their own, their magnetic spins cancel each other out, resulting in an overall lack of magnetic effect. Under specific conditions, these materials can undergo antiferromagnetic-paraferromagnetic transitions. Is it possible to change paramagnetic or ferromagnetic materials by passing a current through them? Altering the magnetism of materials by passing current through them is generally a complex process. Transforming materials into paramagnetic or ferromagnetic states through current flow is not typically straightforward. These types of magnetic materials have spins of atoms or molecules oriented in specific directions, and changing this spin arrangement usually requires external factors such as magnetic fields or temperature changes. Under certain specific conditions, changes in current or temperature could potentially influence the magnetic properties of materials. But these processes often fall within the realm of intricate and specialized research. In general, solely using current flow to change the magnetism of materials to paramagnetic or ferromagnetic states is realistically challenging. It's more effective to manipulate magnetism using external magnetic fields. So, the conclusion is that treating semiconductors with heat and then passing current through them can lead to paramagnetic or ferromagnetic behavior. No, the conclusion is not that straightforward. Treating semiconductors with heat and then passing current through them to induce paramagnetic or ferromagnetic behavior does not align with established physical theories and conventional methods. Changing the magnetic properties of materials is a complex process that typically requires specific and intricate conditions. Generally, changes in the magnetic properties of materials are driven by external factors like magnetic fields or temperature variations. It's challenging to achieve desired changes in magnetic properties solely through heat treatment and current flow. Does that mean that if a semiconductor becomes paramagnetic through current flow, it could also repel magnets and achieve levitation? No, even if a semiconductor becomes paramagnetic through current flow, achieving levitation by repelling magnets is not a straightforward expectation under typical circumstances. The ability of magnets to repel other objects and achieve levitation is determined by the magnetic interaction between objects, and this doesn't necessarily occur simply because a material becomes paramagnetic through current flow. The magnetic properties of paramagnetic materials are primarily determined by interactions between molecules or atoms, and utilizing magnetism for levitation requires additional conditions and complex designs. Therefore, the idea that a semiconductor becoming paramagnetic through current flow would immediately lead to repelling magnets and achieving levitation goes beyond typical concepts governed by established physics laws and research domains. Is copper capable of levitating in the presence of a magnet? No, under typical conditions, copper is not a material that can levitate in the presence of a magnet. While copper possesses magnetic properties that interact with magnets, it does not have the inherent ability to repel a magnet and achieve levitation. Copper is a metal and interacts with magnets primarily through magnetic forces, but it is not generally used to achieve levitation. Levitation-related technologies typically involve the use of other materials or devices to achieve the effect. Enabling copper itself to achieve levitation under standard conditions is realistically challenging. Even if the influence of gravity is minimized, can levitation still occur? Copper is a material that responds to magnets with its inherent magnetic properties, but it does not possess the capability to directly repel a magnet and achieve levitation. Even if the influence of gravity is reduced, the idea of copper levitating through a magnet goes against fundamental principles of physics. Levitation involves manipulating the interaction between forces such as magnetism and gravity to make objects float. It is usually achieved using specialized equipment or materials. The notion of copper itself instantly achieving levitation through magnetic repulsion is considered to be implausible within the realm of known physics. If you place a thin sheet of copper onto a magnet, does it not levitate in mid-air? Yes, that's correct. When you place a thin sheet of copper onto a magnet, under specific conditions, levitation in mid-air can occur. This phenomenon is due to the eddy current effect, where the changing magnetic field induces a current in the copper sheet, creating a magnetic field on the copper itself. This generated magnetic field interacts with the magnet's field, producing a repulsive force that can cause the copper sheet to levitate at a certain height above the magnet. However, achieving this levitation requires specific conditions and design considerations, and not all sizes or thicknesses of copper sheets will levitate above a magnet. Additionally, this phenomenon is temporary and can vary based on the positioning of the copper sheet and the changing magnetic field.